we live it fast and we laugh, reach for a flask. We have to make this moment last. That's plenty. Scratch that. This is not a moment, it's the movement. I may not live to see our glory.
I may not live to see our glory.
But I will gladly join the fight.
But I will gladly join the fight.
And when our children tell our story.
And when our children tell our story.
They'll tell the story of tonight.
Let's have another round tonight.
Let's have another round tonight.
Let's have another round tonight.
Raise a glass to freedom. Something they can never take away. No matter what they tell you. Raise a glass to the four of us. Tomorrow there'll be more of us.
Telling the story of tonight.
They'll tell the story of tonight.
Raise a glass to freedom. Something they can never take away.
No matter what they tell you.
Let's have another round tonight.
Raise a glass to the four of us.
Tomorrow there'll be more of us.
Telling the story of tonight.
Let's have another round tonight.
They'll tell the story of tonight.
Raise a glass to freedom.
They'll tell the story of tonight.
Raise a glass to freedom.
They'll tell the story of tonight.
They'll tell the story of tonight.
There's nothing rich folks love more than going downtown and slumming it with the poor. They pull up in their carriages and gawk at the students in the common just to watch them talk. Take Philip Schuyler, the man is loaded. Uh-oh, but little does he know that his daughters Peggy, Angelica, Eliza sneak into the city just to watch all the guys.
Work, work.
Angelica.
Work, work.
Eliza.
And Peggy.
Work, work. The Schuylers.
Angelica.
Peggy.
Eliza.
Work.
Daddy said to be home by sundown.
Daddy doesn't need to know.
Daddy said not to go downtown.
Like I said, you're free to go.
But look around, look around. The revolution's happening in New York.
New York.
Angelica, work!
It's bad enough Daddy wants to go to war.
People shouting in the square.
It's bad enough there'll be violence on our shore.
No ideas in the air. Look around, look around.
Angelica, remind me what we're looking for.
I'm looking for a mind at work. I'm looking for a mind at
work.
I'm looking for a mind at
work.
There's nothing like summer in the city. Someone in a rush next to someone looking pretty. Excuse me, miss, I know it's not funny, but your perfume smells like your daddy's got money. While you slumming in the city in your fancy heels, you searching for an urchin who can give you ideals.
Sir, you disgust me.
Ah, so you disgust me. I'm a trust fund baby, you can trust me.
I've been reading Common Sense by Thomas Paine. So men say that I'm intense or I'm insane. You want a revolution, I want a revelation. So listen to my declaration. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal. And when I meet Thomas Jefferson, I'ma compel him to include women in the sequel.
Work!
Look around, look around, at how lucky we are to be alive right now. Look around, look around, at how lucky we are to be alive.
And I present free thoughts on the proceedings of the Continental Congress. Heed not the rabble
who scream revolution.
They have not your interest at heart.
Oh my God, tear this dude apart.
Chaos and bloodshed are not a solution. Don't let them lead you astray. This Congress does not speak for me. They're playing a dangerous game. I pray the king shows you his mercy. For shame, for shame.
Yeah. Heed not the rabble. Have you all unravel at the sound of screams? But the revolution is coming.
They have not your interest at heart.
It's hard to listen to you with a straight face.
Chaos and bloodshed
already
haunt
a solution. And even talk.
Don't
and what about Boston?
You
look at the cost and all that we've lost. And you talk
this
about
Congress does not speak for
my
me.
My dog speaks more eloquently
it
than
me. A dangerous dream.
Your mind is
I
the
pray
same.
The king shows you his mercy.
Is he in Jersey?
For shame.
For the revolution. Yourself again, I'm gonna scream. Honestly, look at me, please don't read.
Not your interest.
Don't modulate the key, then not debate with me. Why should a tiny island across the sea regulate the price of tea?
Alexander, please.
Burr, I'd rather be divisive than indecisive. Drop the niceties.
Silence, a message from the king. A message from the king. A message from the king.
The price of my love is not a price that you're willing to pay. You cry in your tea, which you hurl in the sea when you see me go by. Why so sad? Remember we made an arrangement when you went away. Now you're making me mad. Remember, despite our estrangement, I'm your man. You'll be back, soon you'll see. You remember you belong to me. You'll be back, time will tell. You remember that I served you well. Oceans rise, empires fall. We have seen each other through it all. And when push comes to shove, I will send a fully armed battalion to remind you of my love. Da 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 da. You say our love is draining and you can't go on. Subject, my sweet submissive subject, my loyal royal subject, forever and ever and ever and ever and ever. You'll be back like before. I will fight the fight and win the war. For your love, for your praise, and I'll love you till my dying days. When you're gone, I'll go mad. So don't throw away this thing we had. Cause when push comes to shove, I will kill your friends and family to remind you of my love. Da 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 da. Da 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 ya da 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 ya da 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 da.
Scout troops on the water. 32,000 troops in New York Harbor. 32,000 troops in New York Harbor.
As a kid in the Caribbean, I wished for a war. I knew that I was poor, I knew it was the only way to rise up. If they tell my story, I am either gonna die on the battlefield in glory or rise up. I will fight for this land, but there's only one man who can give us a command so we can rise up. Understand, it's the only way to rise up, rise up. Here he comes.
Here comes the general.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Here comes the general.
The moment you've been waiting for.
Here comes the general.
The pride of Mount Vernon.
Here comes the general.
George Washington.
We are outgunned, outmanned, outnumbered, outplanned. We gotta make an all-out stand. Hey yo, I'm gonna need a right-hand man. Check it. Can I be real a second, for just a millisecond? Let down my guard and tell the people how I feel a second. Now I'm the model of a modern major general, the venerated Virginian veteran whose men are all lining up to put me up on a pedestal, writing letters to relatives embellishing my elegance and eloquence. But the elephant is in the room, the truth is in your face when you hear the British cannons go boom. Any hope of success is fleeting. How can I keep leading when the people I'm leading keep retreating? We put a stop to the bleeding as the British take Brooklyn. Night takes Rook, but look, we are outgunned, outmanned, outnumbered, outplanned. We gotta make an all-out stand. Hey yo, I'm gonna need a right-hand man. Incoming!
Battering down the battery, check the damages. We gotta stop them and rob them of their advantages. Let's take a stand with the stamina God has granted us. Hamilton won't abandon ship, yo, let's steal their cannon.
Goes the cannon, watch the blood in this shit spray. And goes the cannon, we're abandoning Kips Bay. And there's another shipping, we just lost the southern tipping. We gotta run to Harlem quick, we can't afford another slip. Guns and horses giddy up, I decide to divvy up my forces. This skittish as the British cut the city up. This close to giving up, facing mass scrutiny. I scream in the face of this mass mutiny. Are these the men with which I am to defend America? We ride at midnight, Manhattan in the distance. I cannot be everywhere at once, people. I'm in dire need of assistance.
Your Excellency, sir.
Who are you?
Aaron Burr, sir. Permission to state my case.
As you were.
Sir, I was a captain under General Montgomery until he caught a bullet in the neck in Quebec. And well, in summary, I think that I could be of some assistance. I admire how you keep firing on the British from a distance. Huh. I have some questions, a couple of suggestions on how to fight instead of fleeing west.
Yes?
Well,
Your Excellency, you wanted to see me.
Hamilton, come in. Have you met Burr?
Yes, sir. We keep meeting.
As I was saying, sir, I look forward to seeing your strategy play out.
Burr,
sir,
close the door on your way out.
Have I done something wrong, sir?
On the contrary, I called you here because our odds are beyond scary. Your reputation precedes you, but I have to laugh.
Sir?
Hamilton, how come no one can get you on their staff?
Sir!
Don't get me wrong. You're a young man of great renown. I know you stole British cannons when we were still downtown. Nathaniel Green and Henry Knox wanted to hire you.
Yeah, to be their secretary, I don't think so.
Now why are you upset?
I'm not.
It's all right you want to fight, you've got a hunger. I was just like you when I was younger. Head full of fantasies of dying like a martyr.
Yes.
Dying is easy, young man. Living is harder.
Why are you telling me this?
I'm being honest. I'm working with a third of what our Congress has promised. We are a powder keg about to explode. I need someone like you to lighten the load. So?
I am not throwing away my shot. I am not throwing away my shot. Ain't no one just like my country.
I am not throwing away my shot.
Son,
we are outgunned, outmanned.
You need all the help you can get. I have some friends, Lawrence Mulligan, Marquis de Lafayette. Okay, what else?
Outnumbered, outplanned.
We'll need some spies on the inside, some king's men who might let some things slide. I'll write to Congress and tell them we need supplies. We rally the guys, master the element of surprise. I'll rise above my station, organize your information till we rise to the occasion of our new nation, sir.
Here comes the general.
Rise up.
But here comes
bastard, orphan, son of a whore, go on and on, grow into more of a phenomenon. Watch this obnoxious, arrogant, loudmouth bother be seated at the right hand of the father. Washington hires Hamilton right on sight, but Hamilton still wants to fight, not right. Now Hamilton's skill with the quill is undeniable, but what do we have in common? We're reliable with the ladies.
There are so many to deflower.
Ladies,
looks, proximity to power.
Ladies,
they delighted and distracted. A Martha Washington named her feral tomcat after him.
That's true.
1780, a winter's ball, and the Schuyler sisters are the envy of all. Yo, if you could marry a sister, you're rich, son.
Is it a question of if Burr or which one?
Hey.
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 Hey. Hey.
Hey.
We were at a revel with some rebels on a hot night, laughing at my sister as she's dazzling the room. Then you walked in and my heart went boom, trying to catch your eye from the side of the ballroom. Everybody's dancing and the band's top volume.
Grind to the rhythm as we whine and dine.
Grab my sister and whisper, yo, this one's mine.
Ooh.
My sister made her way across the room to you.
Ooh.
And I got nervous thinking, what you gonna do?
To change your life.
And by all means, lead the way.
Elizabeth Schuyler, it's a pleasure to meet you.
Schuyler.
My sister. Thank you for all your service.
If it takes fighting a war for us to meet, it will have been worth it.
I'll leave you to it.
1 week later, I'm writing a letter nightly. Now my life gets better every letter that you write me. Laughing at my sister because she wants to form a harem.
I'm just saying, if you really love me, you would share them.
Ha! 2 weeks later, in the living room, stressing. My father's stone-faced while you're asking for his blessing. I'm dying inside as you whine and dine. And I'm trying not to cry, cause there's nothing that your mind can't do. My father makes his way across the room to you. I panic for a second, thinking we're through. But then he shakes your hand and says, be true.
I don't have a dollar to my name, an acre of land, a troop to command, a dollop of fame. All I have is my honor, a tolerance for pain, a couple of college credits and my top-notch brain. Insane, your family brings out a different side of me. Peggy confides in me, Angelica tried to take a bite of me. No stress, my love for you is never in doubt. We'll get a little place in Harlem and we'll figure it out. I've been living without a family since I was a child. My father left, my mother died, I grew up buck wild, but I'll never forget my mother's face, that was real. As long as I'm alive, Eliza, I swear to God you'll never feel so.
I dare with you, I dare with you,
Eliza.
I dare with you, I
never felt so.
You can
All right, that's what I'm talking about. Now, everyone, give it up for the maid of honor, Angelica Schuyler.
A toast to the groom.
To the groom, to the groom, to the groom.
To the bride.
To the bride.
To the bride.
Pleasure to meet you.
Schuyler.
My sister.
Number two.
He's after me because I'm a Schuyler sister that elevates a status side. Have to be naive to set that aside. Maybe that is why I introduce him to Eliza, now that's his bride. Nice going, Angelica, he was right. He will never be satisfied. Thank you for all your service.
If it takes fighting a war for us to meet, it will have been worth it.
I'll leave you to it.
Number three.
I know my sister like I know my own.